Hey YouTube, it's your girl T, and I'm here with Sec. Sec is not only one of the people in the haunted house that scared the hell out of us earlier, but he's also a talented graffiti artist. And this is one of the pieces that he worked on, and this piece is amazing. We took some video of it earlier. So Sec, if you could just tell us, what inspired you to come up with this design here?
This was actually one of our friend, Angelina and Ease. They were here, they were working on this. And then when I came here to work on the piece, they were all like, we want you to do something on one of the pieces, and I was like, all right. So I thought it was gonna be like weeks later, but she threw me a can. She's like, right now, let's do something. And I was like, all right, let's go. So I wrote this first one, and this was kind of one of those things where I looked at it and I was like, all right, this is what I'm feeling. I usually write things when I'm feeling, or I paint things when I'm feeling something. So this is one of those pieces. And then I did another piece around the back outside of this place, and we worked on that together as well. So it was just one of, I don't know, it's just something that was in my head at the time, and I was like, all right, this is what I'm feeling right now, so.
Well, I love it. It's definitely beautiful. So how long did it take you guys, you know, to create something like this?
This one was, it was a day.
You guys did all this in a whole day?
Yeah, it was kind of like one of those things. We work fast. We never stop. It's kind of one of those things where we're like, we lose track of time, and we're just used to it, so it's kind of fun.
Well, you know what they say, when you're having fun and you're doing work, it doesn't even feel like work. So that's amazing. So what does woke up, you know, scratching out, sleeping, woke up, still dreaming, what does that mean to you?
To me, it's like one of those things where, like, woke up, sleeping, where we don't have time to sleep at all. We have to keep going, you know? And then woke up, still dreaming is kind of those things where, like, you're awake, and you see your vision, you see your dream, and no matter what anybody else tells you, it's kind of one of those things that you still see. Like, it's just, it's very vivid, it's there, and it's something you want to accomplish. So it's like, for us, it's a non-stop hustle. It's just keep going, you know? So.
Nice, nice. So do you guys have any other pieces around the city besides here? Okay.
We have four in Los Angeles, in downtown Los Angeles, so this is one. We have another one around back. Actually, we have one in Venice, and then we have a couple of pieces, like, in studios. So we have, like, work scattered around. And then one in New York, actually, but that's...
Oh, wow. Nice. So how does somebody get into graffiti art? Do you have to be a very artistic person? Do you draw on paper first and then put it up on the wall, or are you just able to just look at a wall and just start going at it?
It's different for everybody, kind of, I guess I want to say for that. I started when I was 16, I'm 25 now, but for me, I was just walking around with like a black or white can, and I didn't have like a notebook to write in, so I'd write on whatever wall I had a thought on, you know. So it's kind of like on the thought, inspiration, or a thought, whatever. For somebody else, it's different, you know, like, they sketch on paper and they put it on the wall, but most of the time it's kind of one of those things where, like, they see a wall and they're like, I want that wall. Like, I'm going to take that wall. It's not asking permission, it's just sharing an idea just to get the message across. So.
So then what do you think about people who say that graffiti art is not beautiful, it's vandalism? Because to me it's beautiful and it is artwork. So what do you say to people who feel like, you know, you writing on a wall, that's vandalism, you know, that's vandalizing the wall?
I don't know, for me, like, I have a couple of court cases pending. When I go to in front of judges, they're all like, all right, this is vandalism. To me, it's not vandalism, it's art. To many other people, it's art. To many other people, it's vandalism. It's not what people tell you, it's what you feel. Like, it's what it means to you, it's how you portray your message across to other people, and as long as you're not hurting anyone, and you're getting your message across there, it's not vandalism, it's just another method of speaking, or
expressing yourself. Right. So let me ask you, how important is a place like the Container Yard for people who are graffiti artists? Because so many times they complain they don't want you guys, you know, writing and graffiting up on the walls. But then again, these places are far and few between. So how important is it to have a place like this for you guys to come over here, share your artwork, paint up on the wall and things like that?
It's very important, actually. Thanks to Ash, I remember when he, like, offered everybody to paint in here, it was kind of like one of those things where we were just, like, in Willy Wonka's factory, and we're like, all right, we're painting.
Right.
But then as it came along the time, like, the younger graffiti artists, and then also the kids that didn't think they had enough talent, but they wanted to paint came over. And it's one of those things where they express themselves without having to fear one of those things where, like, okay, I'm going to get in trouble. Or, it's not the right thing to do, you know? Like, here, it's just, I don't know, it's an outlet, and it's also, like, an uplift for people. Like, it's kind of one of those things where, like, it reassures yourself that you're doing the right thing, or you're expressing yourself the right way, and it encourages you to do it more, you know?
Right. On, like, a bigger scale. All right, perfect. Well, thank you so much for interviewing with my audience. I really appreciate it. Once again, your artwork is amazing, and I hope we get an invite to Venice so we can check out the rest of your artwork. Definitely have to come out there. Thank you once again. And before we go, I want to go ahead. Do you have an Instagram, a Twitter, where we can see your artwork? We love to stalk people.
I do. The Instagram is FKN Archangel on Instagram. Right now, I just run on Instagram. Facebook is kind of one of those things that I'm working on, and then I'm working on a website. So.
Okay, so we can find you on Instagram. Perfect, perfect. Well, thank you again for interviewing with me and my channel. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you.